All right, let's try some Pythagorean theorem on isosceles triangles. Okay, if I drop my altitude on an isosceles triangle, all right, what that's going to do is that's going to take my isosceles triangle. And remember, reflexive property from previous lesson, these two triangles are congruent because of HL. So if that happens, what it does on the bottom, cuts our bottom right in half. So the bottom, this is going to be 10. This is going to be 26. I want to find that height. So I'm going to come over here. I'm going to do a squared plus b squared equals c squared. 10 squared plus b squared equals 26 squared, 100 plus b squared equals 676. Subtract 100 from both sides, 576. Square root of 576 is 24. So this is going to be 24. Okay? So now, if I want to find the perimeter of this guy, I'm going to just move up here. Perimeter is going to be, that side's 26, this is 26. We just take 26 plus 26 plus the 20 on the bottom. Add them all up. We get perimeter's 72 feet. The area, use the area formula off our formula sheet. 1/2 of base times height, so 1/2 of the base, which was 20. And the height which you found, 24, half of 20 is 10, that's 24, so the area is going to be 240 feet squared. That's great. Let's try another one. All right, we're going to find the perimeter area of this isosceles triangle. So let's do the perimeter first. That's going to be super easy. This is 17, that's 17 because they're tick marks. Plus 16, perimeter equals, just add up the three sides. So the perimeter is going to be equal to 50 feet. Now, if I want to find the area, got 1/2 of base times height. My base is 16. We got to find the height. 17 is not the height. I'm going to drop this height down here. There's your height. Remember, it cuts this in half. So that's 8 and 8. So I have a triangle that looks like this. With an 8, a 90, 17. Going to find this guy. 8 squared plus x squared equals 17 squared. 8 squared, 64. 289. Subtract 64 from both sides. X is equal to 15. So this is 15, which is my height. 1/2 of 16 is 8. 8 times 15 is 120 feet squared for my area. Okay, hope you found this lesson informative and helpful, and we'll see you on the next video.